Good morning students, today's topic is estimation of uric acid. Now what is uric acid? It is end product of purine catabolism. It is mainly synthesized in liver and intestinal mucosa. It is excreted 2/3 via kidney and 1/3 via GI tract. What is the normal value? In male it is 2.5 to 7 mg per dl. In female it is 1.9 to 6 mg per dl. Now what are the condition where it may increase? One is renal failure, gout, it may be asymptomatic hypercalciuria, increased destruction of nucleoprotein such as in leukemia, lymphoma, multiple myeloma, cancer chemotherapy, drugs such as vincristine, prednisone, nitrogen masters, polycythemia, hemolytic anemia, sickle cell anemia, toxemia of pregnancy, in metabolic acidosis, diet, in high protein diet or alcohol intake. There are some miscellaneous causes such as von Wiechert's disease, chronic lead poisoning, Lisch-Nihan syndrome, maple syrup urine disease, Down syndrome, hypothyroidism, hypoparathyroidism, primary hyperparathyroidism. There are some drugs that may also cause increased uric acid level. Most common is thiazide diuretics used in treatment of hypertension. Some intoxication drugs such as barbiturates, ammonia, carbon monoxide. Now what are the conditions where it may decrease? One is ACTH, another one is urotoxic drugs. Some disease where it may decrease is Wilson's disease, Fanconi's anemia, acromegaly and in psoriatic arthritis. Now we may find uric acid. Normal value is 24 hours in urine sample, it is 250 to 750 milligram per day. In case of random urine sample in male, it is less than 600 milligram per gram of creatinine. In female it is less than 740 milligram per gram of creatinine. What are the causes where it may increase or decrease? Causes are same such as in blood uric acid level. Now next is estimation of uric acid. Sample, it may be serum, it may be plasma. Anticoagulant used in plasma is EDTA or heparin. If we use urine for estimation of uric acid, first we should add NaOH in collection bottle. What is the significance of adding NaOH? Because it keeps the medium alkaline, otherwise uric acid will be deposited. Before assay in urine sample, we should dilute the sample in 1:9 dilution. Now what are the methods? There are different methods that can be used for uric acid estimation. One is phosphotransferic acid method. What is the principle of this method? In this, phosphotransferic acid is reduced by uric acid in alkaline medium to produce a blue color compound, that is tungsten blue, and it is measured photometrically in semi auto analyzer or auto analyzer at 650 nanometer. There are some problem using this method. Interfering substances may give positive result. So this is not most commonly used. Most commonly used is uricase method. Wavelength is 505 nanometer. What is the principle of this method? Here first uricase acts upon uric acid to produce allantoin carbon dioxide and hydrogen peroxide. Now this hydrogen peroxide in presence of peroxidase reacts with 4 amino antipyrene dye to produce a red color compound, that is quinoimine dye. This is measured photometrically in 505 wavelength. Another method is HPLC method. It is very very sensitive, but problem is it is very much costly, so not commonly used. In HPLC method, we use ion exchange or reverse phase column. Now, gout. This is the most common cause where uric acid is measured. What is gout? It is a type of arthritis that causes swelling of different joint. Most commonly is distal phalanx of first great toe or great toe, rather great toe. What is the diagnosis? Most common diagnosis is in synovial fluid. We detect presence of intracellular or extracellular needle shaped negatively charged birefringent monosodium urate crystals by using polarizing microscopy. We also measure uric acid. If it is increased, we also go for some screening test. What are the screening tests that are commonly used in case of gout? One is CBC, urine analysis, LFT, urea creatinine, and also in some cases we measure thyroid level. What is the treatment of gout? One is restriction of diet. High protein diet is restricted, and we also ask the patient not to take alcohol. Another one is symptomatic, to give relief from the pain. What are the drugs that are used? One is non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, that is mainly painkiller, and also we use steroids. And what is the specific management? We use uricosuric drugs. What are the uricosuric drugs that we use? One is allantoin, another one is febuxostat. Now this is how we measure uric acid and what is the significance of measuring uric acid. This is all for today.